Dr. Jaffe, can you explain what parvalbumin is?
Now that's an interesting and sophisticated question. Parvalbumin, it is a protein. It is an albumin-related protein. It is specifically a calcium mineral divalent cation, but let's say calcium binding albumin protein. It's low molecular weight. It's about 10,000 Daltons, which means that it can be easily identified in the urine. It is similar to calmodulin and troponin. It is found in muscles, and the twitch muscles, the muscles that contract fastest, have the highest level. Also found in the brain and in the neurohormonal tissues. It's a small, stable protein that binds calcium because of the electrostatics. This is non-covalent. This means the minerals come on and off. And so this is a transporter of minerals like calcium. Scientists have broken this down into different motifs and domains, but that has no importance to mere consumers or clinicians. That is only important if you're a real molecular biochemist. But these calcium-binding proteins play a role in many physiologic processes. For example, cell division, second messenger production. Calcium is one of the second messengers balanced by magnesium. And I think it was 1975, I know that I was at NIH, when a very distinguished scientist ran down the hall screaming Eureka, because he figured out that calcium and magnesium were secondary amplifiers of messages that caused cells to divide. It's also involved in muscle contraction. It's involved with microtubules, the things that hold nerves and cell structures together. They're also phototransducers. So if incoming light comes to such parvalbumin, you can capture that energy. And clinically, there is much interest in neurodegenerative diseases, including Alzheimer's. Prion-related conditions have a lot to do with parvalbumin. They have a lot to do with impaired protein synthesis at the same time that you have cell acidosis, cell metabolic acidosis, that induces impaired protein synthesis. In a healthy alkaline cell, 90, 95, 98% of what is produced by the system of the body, the ribosomes, the translation of the DNA into the RNA, from RNA into the proteins, 95% of that is properly done. It goes through quality control in the cell and it's ready for use. But if you have lack of magnesium and therefore loss of the proton gradient, the battery mitochondria begins to shut down. And as a consequence, abnormal proteins, abnormally shaped proteins, are allowed through the quality control system. And they can cause problems. And that is associated with opportunistic, unhealthy prions rather than commensal, apparently benign prions. So age-related cognitive defects are related to parvalbumin. Parvalbumin is a calcium-binding protein. It can be measured in the urine. It's part of free albumin in the urine. It is smaller than the full albumin molecule, but it's antigenically related. It's structurally and sequentially related. And what it seems to have to do with is amplifying messages using calcium or calcium and magnesium.